Okay. This is our new topic, budding. Budding, that means, is a form of grafting. Well, mature bud is inserted in the stock plant in such a way that the proper union will take place. Okay, so this is the type of vegetative propagation like budding, but only difference is in budding, we use a mature bud. In grafting, we use a scion, small age scion, and this is the vegetative propagation. So the edges of budding, it is the best propagation method if the propagating material is scarce and valuable. This is the advantages of budding. If we have some material is very in a scarce amount, so that way that's why we can use this budding method. Budding is useful in a plant which release excessive worm gum, stone fruits from injury caused to wood portion of the stem at the time of grafting. Sometime at the time of grafting, grafting operation, the plants may cause some injury. So that's why at that time we can use bud or budding method. Then budding union is a stronger than grafting. Damage by wind and storms is less compared to the grafted plants. Budding is comparatively simple, efficient, and quicker method of propagation than the grafting. But the disadvantages of budding is it's require skilled labor for the carried out for this budding operation. Selection of how to select a bud. First, while selecting the bud wood, one should careful enough to use vegetative buds than the flowering buds for budding. Okay, so at the time of budding, first is the selection of bud. So the bud, age of the bud is very important for the budding operation, and we use only vegetative bud, not a flowering bud. The vegetative buds are usually small and pointed, while flower buds are large and plump. In case of bud wood, to be procured from a distant place and leaves must be removed by leaving petiole intact. Okay, so in the vegetative propagation, small bird or pointed birds are and healthy birds should be select. The bundle of bird wood should be packed in a moist jute and sphagnum moss clothes and should be kept moist in the transit. If you take a bird from the distant place, that time you can pack the birds in a moist jute bag or a sphagnum moss or cloth. First method of budding is the shield budding, or it is also called as tea budding. The name given for this method of budding is tea budding because the shape of the bud is given on the rootstock is the T shape. T shape is cut given on the rootstock, so that is why it is called as T budding or shield budding. It is the most common method of budding used by nurserymen and worldwide. This is the most common method of budding. This type of budding mostly used in bear, amla, then custard apple, etc. For shield budding, 1 year old rootstock seedlings of 25 to 35 centimeter height and 2 to 2.5 centimeter thickness is selected. So the selection criteria for the rootstock is 1 year old rootstock select for the budding operation, and the height of that rootstock is 25 to 35 centimeter. And thickness is 2 to 2.5 centimeter. Okay, then the bark of the seedling should be slip easily. For the budding operation, the bark is removed for the at the time of operation, so the bark can be slip easily. So this is the rootstock is very useful for the budding operation. Then the selected bud of desired cultivar is inserted 15 to 20 centimeter above the ground level and is tied with the polythene strip. Or performing budding operation, a T-shaped cut is made on the selected portion of the stalk with the help of sharp budding knife. This is a budding. How to carry out budding? First, the desired bud cultivar is inserted 15 to 20 centimeter above the ground level. And after the buds are inserted into the root stock, then these are tied with the polythene strip. Okay, or performing the budding operation, T-shaped cut is made on the selected portion of the stock with the help of sharp knife. That is called as budding knife or a grafting knife. Okay, then the incision should be given through the bark, not on wood. Okay, so the cut of T-shaped cut given only on the bark, not on wood. The two flaps of the bark are also loosened with the help of budding knife. The healthy bud is removed from the bud wood by cutting shallow, about 5 to 6 mm below the 2.2 to 3 centimeter above the bud. Okay, this is the how to remove bud from the scion portion other plant. Healthy bud is removed from the bud wood by cutting shallow 5 to 6 mm below and 2 to 3 centimeter above the bud. Okay, the shield piece containing bud is inserted in the T-cut made on the rootstock. The bud inserted into the T-shaped cut given on the rootstock. Then the shield should be covered with by two flaps of the bark, but bud should be exposed. Okay, at the time of wrapping of the polythene, bud should be exposed. And only the bark slabs or the bark should be covered with the polythene strip. The buds are pressed firmly, fitted into the T-cut and finally tied with the polythene strip. When bud healing process is over, the bud may attain a height of 15 to 20 centimeter and remaining portion of the stalk is cut about 10 to 15 centimeter above the bud. Okay, this type of budding is mostly preferred in apple, pear, peach, apricot, cherry, rose, and citrus. In this picture, we can see how we do the shield budding. First is the in the first picture. This is the budding knife and cutting of bark on the rootstock. This is the rootstock and the cutted portion of the rootstock. Okay, the T shape given on the rootstock. This is the T shape given on rootstock, and this is the slip flap of the bark. Okay, this is the flap of bark, and this is the T shape. Okay, and the bud are inserted in this place. Okay. And after the placing of bud, the flap is covered with the place, but only the bud portion is exposed to the exposed. And after that, the polythene strip, white polythene strips are covered with the with that budding portion. Okay. Next one method is the chip budding. Chip budding is done early in the morning, summer or autumn. In chip budding, chip bark of wood is removed from the smoother surface between the nodes of the stalk. In chips, in chip of a similar size, shape is removed from bud wood of the desired cultivar. The budding operation is the same in all methods, but only the shape of the or the portion of bud and rootstock portion is different, but the method is same. Okay, then for which 2 to 3 centimeter long downward cut is made in made through the bark and slightly into the wood of the stock. Then the second cut of about 2.5 centimeter is made so that the bisects of first cut at the angle of 30 to 35 degree and the chip is removed from the stock. In this method, we use a single chip from the scion bud and inserted into the rootstock. In this picture, we can see how to do chip budding. Okay, this is the chip removed from the budwood cultivar, and this is the rootstock. Okay, this is the rootstock cut given on the like a chip, and the budded chip is inserted in this rootstock, and after that the wrapping process. Similarly, chip of bud is removed from the budwood, ensuring that the bud is in the middle of chip. The bud chip inserted in the stalk in such way that the cambium of the bud chip should be direct contact with the cambium of the stalk. This is the cambium tissue. Okay, after removing of chip from the rootstock, this cutted portion is called as cambium portion. Okay, then the chip of bud is inserted into this cutted portion, and both the cambium tissue are meet with each other after bud chip and cut is given on the rootstock. Okay, then after wrapping, it is then tightly wrapped with the polythene strip, leaving the bud uncovered. The bud may be sprout after 3 to 4 weeks, and afterwards the wrapping material should be removed. When the bud start growing, the stalk may be cut above the bud union. And this type of method mostly used in custard apple and mandarin. After 3 to 4 weeks, the sprouting is occur in budded portion. After that, the wrapping material should be removed and bud start growing. The stalk may be cut above the bud union. The sprouted portion or the sprouted portion cut from the that place and insert into the another place or planted into the another place. And if the sprouting is not occur after 3 to 4 weeks of budding operation, that means the operation is failed. Sometimes the mortality may be occur on this. Okay, then next one is the patch budding. This is the patch. Okay, this is the scion bud and this is the rootstock. Okay, the patch portion is cut from the scion bud, and this is inserted into the rootstock. Okay, this is the bud. In case of patch bud, the rectangular patch of bark is removed completely from the rootstock and replaced with the patch of bark of the same size containing bud of the cultivar to be propagated. Okay, same shape cut on both that means scion portion and rootstock. Rectangular shape mostly cut. It is slower and difficult to perform method than the T-budding. It is widely used in a thick bark spaces such as walnut, pecan nut, and rubber trees, where the T-budding gives a poor result due to poor fit around the margins of the bud, particularly the top and bottom. This method is usually done in the later summer or early fall, but can be done in the spring also. The patch of the budding rootstock and scion should be preferably be a same thickness, 20 to 25 mm. Okay, same thickness or same shape is cut on the both stand and rootstock faces. First, a rectangular piece of bark 25 mm long and 10 to 15 cm wide is removed from the stock, and a similar patch containing a bud is removed from the scion by making two horizontal cuts above or below the bud, and then two vertical cuts connecting the horizontal cut. After removing the patch, the bud should be fit tightly at the top and bottom, then wrap with polythene strip and keeping the bud uncovered with polythene. Wrapping material should be hold the bark tightly and cover all the cut surface to prevent free entry of air, water and pathogens. Okay, so at the time of wrapping of polythene, it should be hold the bark tightly, because sometimes the cut surface the entry of pathogens, air and water may be occur. So that's why to prevent the entry of that air, water and pathogens, it should be tightly wrapping is important. After the bud starts sprouting, the stalk above the bud union may be cut off step by step. In addition, the pecan nut and walnut, mango, rubber, plum, amla, jackfruit, jam are also propagated by this method. This is a patch method. This is the bud stick. Okay, this is the bud stick, and on the patch portion, this is bud, and this is the stalk. Remove bark, rectangular shape from the stalk. And then the cutted portion of bud is inserted into this place. Okay, this is in this picture you can see. After fitting of bud patch on the rootstock, then wrap with the polythene strip. Then a ring or angular budding. In this type of budding, a complete ring of bark is removed from the stalk and it is completely girdled. Ring, that means the ring shape of bark completely removed from the stalk portion, from the root stalk. A similar ring of bark containing a bud is removed from the bud stick and is inserted on the root stalk. Okay, first we have cut a ring of bark from the root stalk, then similar ring of bark containing bud is removed from the bud stick. After that, it is inserted onto the rootstock. The thickness of stalk and scion should be same size. It has been utilized in bear, jam, peach, mulberry, because newly emerged shoots from the heavily pruned plants are capable of giving such buds for budding, which can easily separate it. In this method, since the stalk is completely girdled, and if the bud fails to heal, then the stalk above the ring may be eventually die. In this picture, we can see how to remove the ring from rootstock and scion portion. This is the scion portion with a bud. Okay, and this is the rootstock. The cutted portion of ring rootstock. This portion are inserted into this rootstock and then wrap with polythene strip. Then forked budding. Forked budding means in forked budding, the stalk is prepared by giving two vertical cuts and a transverse cut above the vertical cuts to join them. First, this is the forked budding. First, remove the bark in a particular shape from the rootstock. Not completely remove, only flap type of bark remove from the rootstock. And then after inserting the bud, the flap portion covered with this bud portion, that is scion bud, and bud should be uncovered After flapping off this bar, then cover with the polythene strip and after 2 to 3 weeks, the sprouting may be occur in this place. Okay. A bark is removed carefully along the cut so that the flap of the bark hangs down. The sign is prepared in a fashion similar to patch budding, having the size similar to cuts made on the stalk. Okay. Same as like the patch budding, only the flap of bark take on the rootstock. The sign is then slip into the exposed portion of the stalk and the flap is down drawn over the inserted bud patch. It is then tied with the suitable wrapping material. After successful growth of bud, the portion of stalk above the union is removed carefully. And this type of method mostly used in mango. Then fluid budding. In fluid budding, the patch of bark is removed from the stalk in such way that it is almost completely encircle the stalk stalk, except with narrow bark connection between the upper and lower cuts on the stalk. This is the fluid budding. Okay. A ring-like portion removed from the stalk portion. Similar bark of similar patch of bark is removed from the bud stick containing a healthy buds. Then the shield cutting the bud is then inserted in the vacant area of the stalk and then shield should be fit tightly on the stalk. This is the stalk portion and this is the ring shape bark removed from that portion. And after that, the sign bud, same like shape, same like patch cut from the sign bud, only containing the bud on that bark. Then the cyan bud fitted into the rootstock portion, then wrapped with polythene. It is then wrapped with a suitable polythene material, wrapping material, leaving a bud uncovered. The other procedure is the same in the patch budding because of the presence of narrow connecting strips of bark on the stalk. It is remains alive even if the bud fails to sprout. This method is mostly used in the bear and cashew nut. This is the fluid budding. So this is all about budding operation.